instances of time. Feel the relaxation in your shoulders, how they start to really fall and drop down. Feel the weight of your legs, in your knees. And slowly start getting all your attention towards your body. Closing your outer attention and bringing them all in. Just observe your breathing with them. Your physical sensations right now, after one day has passed. You might feel anything that reflects in your body of today. Maybe there are some emotions, maybe there are some memories, some desires. Just connect with anything there is. And start feeling those exhalations as tool of rooting down. Feeling the connection with the earth, with the floor. And that relaxation that comes with it. Centering anything that happens within that beautiful body. Bring your chin a little more in. So you tuck it, let it hang a little more, but push it backwards. So feel the extension in your neck. And feel at the same time how your shoulders keep relaxing down. How you are creating space in your neck and in your entire spine. You're starting to expand each inhalation and each exhalation. Feel this beautiful movement in your upper body. And like that, slowly your thoughts are getting more loose in your minds. There's more and more disattachment to them. Let's bring our palms together to the center of our chest.
A gesture for our very selves. To open our very personal practice today.
To practice in a very conscious way, listening to our own body and letting it guide us through the entire practice. Take a deep inhale through your nose and exhale, incline your head.
Let your shoulders drop down and exhale until there's no more air left to exhale.
Slowly release your hands on top of your knees and open your eyes. So it might have helped you a little bit more to really arrive at the present moment, to bring all your thoughts onto the mat or even closer into your physical body. And we're just starting to get more active in our upper body and feel our breathing rhythm, how it guides us. So literally feel first breathing and then moving.
In your exhalation, just release all the air that you have in your lungs and drop back as much as you can. Your chin falls down. If you manage to have your arms straight, wonderful. Just feel how your shoulder blades are expanding behind. And in your inhalation, keeping your arms straight, pull your chest out and up as much as you can, bringing your shoulder blades together.
Your throat is growing up. And exhale again, take it really deep and drop back. Your chin
touches your chest. Inhale, strengthen your arm, pull yourself forward.
Shoulder blades are together. Feel that lightness in your chest and exhale one more time. Inhale. And with this very movement, feel that each time you're traveling deeper into the posture, you feel yourself more connected with it. You become aware of your breathing. And in your next exhalation, bring both of your hands on top of the mat in table pose. Still continuing to breathe. So push your air out and find a very round back. Like an angry cat, we would say, push into the floor, activate your arms there, your hands, feel the power. Inhale, just the opposite, open your chest again, but feel that activation in your lower back.
Shoulder blades together, exhale again. Inhale one more time here.
Find this very nice arch arch in your back, but a very open chest, and find your neutral position. I would just like to show you a way to even mobilize more our back and our spine. So we're starting a wavy shape. We're starting literally from our hips, which are moving to push our rest of our spine forward, and then start again to collapse. You might even help yourself a little bit more with moving forward and backwards, but just feel that you're just moving your spine, incorporating your neck. Always when you come back, you start rounding until you come forward and start opening until you come backwards. Super. One more time, find your neutral tabletop pose, and we start to get more into our concentration. Keep breathing where you are. We're going to extend our right arm forward and our left leg back. So for now, it might be already tricky. Find an even level of your arm and of your leg back. Take all your air out and bring your knee and elbow together and push up. So you want to have a round back. Inhale this time, pull up as much as you can. Open, 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 open. And exhale one more time. Push all the air out. Knee comes high, high, high. Inhale, one more time up. And this time, the knee which is in the back, just cross it behind your right knee. Right arm comes up in your next inhalation, open here. Super. In your next inhalation, we start just bringing our hands forward again and land on the floor. We're getting in the other side, straightening. You can put your toes on the mat, or you stay there with your entire foot. In your exhalation, push all your air out, round your back, push into your right arm, inhale, open up more, find arching, find a lot of arching. And exhale, one more time, all the air goes out, and up. Inhale, open, 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 open. And in your exhalation, the back knee just crosses with the front knee. Lift up your left arm this time, bring it back as much as you can, but feel your hips as well. Exhale, both hands go down. We uncross again. Find a neutral position, take a deep inhale, and this time just helps us to push back. So your hip is the first that comes up, and you might stay with your knees flexed. Bend just one knee and then the other and get comfortable in that very first downward facing dog. Adho Mukha, your head is relaxed. Your head is as much as you can behind your hands, which are activating, pushing into the floor. Slowly in your next exhalation, walk towards the front of your mat, towards your hands. Take a deep inhale to straighten your back. That's the first time we're actually feeling what's about our legs today. Try to activate. You have a strong back, straight, straight arms, exhale, bend down. At this time, bend your knees as much as you can. Take a deep inhale and roll up vertebra by vertebra. Feel them smooth and in harmony with each other. Open your chest, samasthiti. A nice neutral standing position. So find yourself looking in front. Your shoulders are relaxed, but your arms and fingertips are activated, as if there would be energy that you still want to come out of your fingertips. The next inhalation, bring your hands up, try to expand your entire body as much as you can to the ceiling, and exhale, just all the way out, bend forward. Inhale, lengthen the spine, lengthen your neck as well, and in your exhalation, you choose if you step or jump into your plank pose. Bend down in the same exhalation, and inhale, open up. So if you want to take it smooth today, you can stay down with your knees. If you want to activate a little more, just push them away from the floor, opening more through your chest. And exhale, try again to find that way. First, it's the hip that comes up, and at last, your head is tucking in. So once more, feel the pressure on your fingers and on your arms, pushing backwards all the weight towards your legs. In your next inhalation, from here, bring your right leg back up. Keep your downward facing dog. And exhale, bend that knee over. So the right heel is actually looking for the floor. staying to you in your downward facing. And from here,
you actually start to release your left hand from the floor and walk it more to the left side.
So we're making like a tripod, Adho Mukha. You want to have less weight as possible on that very left arm. Slowly walk back, inhale here, straighten up. Exhale, bend that knee into your front. So just bring the knee as high as you can. Inhale, bring that knee down between your hands and lengthen your spine.
Exhale, push up again. Inhale, back up.
And this time we go one more time into that bending the knee over. And you can just repeat the same thing we did. Walk out the left hand, more to the left side. Since it's the day of concentration, you might look for that upper leg with that very same left arm on top.
So it's the wrist of the right foot that you're looking for.
Straighten through your left leg and right arm. Take yourself the time to find it. Keep breathing, and whenever you find a way back, inhale, lengthen, and exhale, land. Super! The first part is always the hardest. Now you already know where we are going. In your next inhalation, left leg goes back up. Exhale, bend that knee and just connect with that feeling of bringing out your right arm and keep connecting with your down-facing dog.
So your left arm is super straight and just your right fingertips are on the floor. Slowly walk back.
Inhale, lengthen your knee and your leg up. Exhale, push all your air out. Make a round back and shift all the weight on top of your hands. Inhale, bring that knee down. Lengthen your spine, shoulder blades together. And exhale, push up. Inhale, come back up all the way. And that's our preparation to exhale. Bend that knee and find the variation again. So go step by step. You can stay with your fingertips, of course, on the floor.
If you want to challenge yourself with some more concentration,
I feel that there's a different side today. Don't force yourself into that position. If it doesn't want to happen, it's much more better that you just accept it and exhale, find your downward facing dog. Take a deep inhale.
Exhalation, bend your knees. Look forward, step or jump into the front. Take an inhale here and exhale.
We go one more time. Inhale all the way up. And exhale back down. Uddanasana. Inhale, lengthen your spine. Feel
as at last your chin is actually helping your neck to extend. Both hands to the floor, step or jump into your plank pose. Elbows stay together and bend down. Inhale, tap your chin and roll up.
Push against the floor. Exhale, Adho Mukha. Very, very nice. And your next inhalation, we're going to bring up our right leg again. Exhale, once more, activate your center. Navel goes in and push your knee towards your front head. Super nice. This time,
let your left heel behind just drop down. And straighten that right leg forward. Inhale, open up your chest.
You can stay here, relax a little more opening,
or you can try to find a bind with the outer side of your right foot and pushing forward.
So this requires really a lot of strength, pushing down through your right arm. Exhale, both hands back to the mat. Inhale, look, come back up, and exhale. Super. You're changing sides. Inhale, left leg goes back up. And exhale, activate your center, rounding your back, pushing into the mat. Keep your knee high and slowly drop your right heel down. Extend your leg, opening your legs as much as you can and roll up your hips, open. You can stay here. You can swipe your leg towards your hand and extend here. Playing a little more with all those limbs. Exhale, both hands to the floor. Inhale, open that space again. And exhale, Adho Mukha. Take a deep inhale here. Exhale, bend your knees, step or jump in between your hands. Open up your chest, lengthen your spine. Inhale, come all the way back up. Maybe a little bit more shift over to open your chest a little more. And exhale, Samasthiti. We're going into the next round. Surya Namaskara Ve. Inhaling, touch the floor, stay low with your knees bent and just bring up your hands. Try to keep your back super flat and nice. Exhale, bend down. Inhale, lengthen your spine, lengthen your legs. And exhale, this time really try to shift your weight first on top of your hands, maybe bring up your heels and then swipe back. Lower down and inhale, open up your chest. Urdhva Mukha. Exhale, Adho Mukha, downward facing dog. Inhale, your right leg goes behind between your hands. Come up with both arms. And try first of all to square your hips. Opening up more. Two. One. A little bit more of concentration. Inhale, bring your back heel up. Really lengthening through the back leg. And exhale, open up your fingers and your hands and twist over your right shoulder. Follow your gaze towards your right hand. Two. One, that's it. Exhale, your front arm just goes to the mat. And inhale, one more time, twist. Feel that spine. Super. If you want to go even deeper, you can bring down your knee and look for your wrist. And open up a little more. If not, you can always just stay there and feel it twist a little more. Exhale, both hands go down. It's your decision, since today it's rocket, to just step back or to make that transition of a good vinyasana and then come into your downward facing dog, passing a chaturanga. And we're going to the other side. Inhale, left leg goes in between your hands. Find your warrior, find your square hips, find the pushing through your back leg, find your chest open, inhale, bring your heel up, and exhale, really open those hands, and twist over. It's important that your entire upper body is relaxed on top of your hips, not in front, and also not behind, just on top, or it can relax. Exhale, right arm goes down, and inhale, bring that upper arm as much as you can behind, follow it with your gaze, and find your variation, if you did it so, in the other side. If you go onto the floor, it's more about your hips even, who sink more in. Exhale, both hands to the floor, find your transition, your way, maybe the easy one, maybe the little bit more tough one today. To your downward facing dog. In your next exhalation, bend your knees, look into the front and feel your hips just for a moment really light by jumping a little higher, keeping your legs always heavy. Inhale, straighten forward and exhale, bend down. Inhale, Utkatasana, bend your knees, bring your hands up, interlace your fingers and we stay here. Starting with a small rocket sequence, so our back is straight, our hands are pushing up, activate through your elbows, two, feel slightly more weight on top of your heels, your ribs are very nice and close, and exhale, half version, feel your legs burning, your entire upper body is parallel to the floor, two, one, exhale, interlace your fingers in the back, take a deep inhale, lengthen and exhale, bend over. The last thing that straightens are your legs. And feel that weight in your arms, opening your shoulders, straightening through your elbows again, activating here. So your legs are as much as they can straight. Slowly, by keeping your chin really tearing down, so your chin wants to touch the mat. But your hips, at the same time, they want to rise up. Open your mind and find that shifting up to your metatarsus to release all weight from your heels. So feel the knees very strong. Your entire legs are hard. They're super, super engaged. And your heels are rising, rising, rising up. Your and slowly come down with your hands. Stay high with your heels. And it's the moment for our bakasana. So for today, we're playing a little more. If you have that bakasana, I leave different options. You might just try today your bakasana. If you're really comfortable with your bakasana today, just give it a try. You might need a cushion if you're not that safe yet. Come up into your posture. Lower down and shift your head, tucking your chin to come to your tripod headstand. So it's all about transitions that you're looking for. And if you got in, try to find your way out again. Just back to come up, ooh, and stay in your bakasana. You can stay in for 5 breathings at least. Find your way back through jumping, lowering down, until you breathe and relax for some moments in Adho Mukha, downward facing dog. When we're all there, inhale, your right leg goes between your hands.
Interlace your fingers and find your warrior again. So you have very squared hips,
a very extended upper back. 2, 1. In your next inhalation, straighten your front leg, find your arms super extended forward
and bring them towards the floor. Take another inhale, lengthen your spine, and exhale, relax
and bring your upper back in line with your front leg. If you're really, really comfortable here, you can bring your hands up towards your shin, wherever you like it. Keep straightening through both of your legs. 2, 1. In your next inhale,
slightly pushing, find your warrior one again.
And exhale, open into your warrior 2. So this time you want to have both of your hips in line with your front knee and in line with your back heel. Just feel it, just see it. Your shoulders are relaxed. 2, 1. From here, exhale, your left arm slides down your left leg. Feel that you're still bending your front knee and open up the space in your ribs on the right side. The more you bend your front knee, the more it gets intense. 2, stay looking up the ceiling. 1, inhale, come all the way back up.
Lengthen through your front leg and exhale, find Uddiyana Trikonasana.
For those who know that posture and are really comfortable in it, your hand goes straight to the floor, looking up. And if you're still comfortable here, that upper arm can look through the back towards your right leg muscle. Just try aligning your shoulders. 1 is on top of the other. 2, both legs are straight. 1, exhale, both hands are going down. We're shortening the distance a little bit. Actually, this is a very tricky posture and I've struggled so much with getting to it, but now it's just a moment to try. So we have already that focus on having a really long upper body. Stay that long you are, just focus on your front leg.
Walk backwards with your fingers looking back. So you want to just lay on that front leg, which is really extended far from you.
Shape a triangle with your forearm and your shins. And from there, push as much as you can into that fingertips. Okay, push, 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 push. Activate your upper back and start bending your back knee into your chest. So maybe you resist that weight for 3, 2, 1, and exhale, bend down. Super nice. That's really about body architecture here. And swipe over, your left arm comes to the outside part of your right foot.
Push into it to elevate your upper body, your chest especially, and come into your body with a Trikonasana. 2, 1.
You always can use a block here, so if it's too hard, just place a block under your arms. That's especially for Uddiyana Trikonasana. In your exhalation, look to the floor, walk forward with your left hand and find just a short flight into your Parivrita Ardha Chandrasana. If you're safe and comfortable here, just stay here too. Any variations always welcome, and if not, we're starting to find another variation, walking out with your left hand, tick, 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 bending your back knee as much as you can. Actually, both knees are bending. For the strong ones, you can make a bind with your left outside foot and your right arm, straightening it. Use your left arm to support the weight, maybe come to sit. Super. That's actually a transition that I really enjoy lately. Walk forward as much as you can, so your knee is looking forward. And exhale with open elbows, bend lower. You can make the bind and just lengthen through your chest. Super. Inhale, come up. Activate again. Both hands come back to the front, so exactly where you are. Let your left heel drop again and find your extended ankle pose. Right elbow is on top of the right knee. If you are comfortable with any variations here, you can make a bind. But you also can go deeper by bringing your head down and sinking more in with your hips. Wherever you go, stay there. Three. If you make a bind, now it's the moment to start replacing your heels with your hand and feel that pressure through your right hand is actually releasing the weight from your right foot. You can grab with your left hand the outside part of the right foot and start bringing it up. So maybe today this is what you do. If you feel comfortable by pushing through your right arm, start straightening that right foot and expanding a little more. Two. Wherever you go, breathe. Be aware of yourself. One. Both hands go down. Front foot goes down. Knees go down. And lengthening forward again. Checking into our hips. Super nice. Straightening our back. Slowly come forward. So it's actually we're pushing ourselves far from our knee. Inhale, come all the way up with your left hand, and exhale. Make that space small around your belly, pull it in, and find your twist. Feel again that really nice twist in your spine. You want to bring your right shoulder blade more towards your spine. Just feel how you're pulling it in again. If you want to come fly bind again, or even straighten your back leg. Always sealing the posture with your gaze towards the ceiling. Two. One. Exhale down, release. And your moment has come to start practicing the pincha. So we have already done it in the other rounds. If you're already aware with the pincha, if you know it, just go for it. Forearms go down. The preparation would always be the dolphin. It would help us to find that consciousness in keeping our hips high. So they want to be high. Think of that position by rolling up your hips. That's the same we want to do in the scorpion. And pushing up one leg, helping with the other one to shift over that weight on top of our elbows. And just change sides. There is a little impulse, but especially you want to reach that line without jumping too much, without losing that control of your power. The more you push through your elbows, the more power you get in stabilizing that posture. Really nice. And just feel it. If you are in your pincha, stay there, feeling that line, feeling the concentration. If you want to feel more glance of concentration here, you can always challenge yourself by shifting your gaze, looking towards your toes, looking slowly back. And here I would like to make a remark. We are going to practice that by end of today's class. So we're making this as only exercise for now, and then at the end of the class we're repeating the pincha in a different entrance. So So just maybe feel the pinch up for now, or try it, and find your own personal way back into Adho Mukha. In your next inhalation from here, you find your left leg between your hands. Find your warrior, interlace your fingers and bring it up. Two. One. Super nice. In your inhalation, straighten your front leg. Your hands go far in front and feel an extension through your spine. Bring only your fingertips to the floor. Give yourself another inhalation to lengthen and exhale. On top of your very straight leg, just bend over. Both legs are straight. Feel that spine extending. Two. One. In another inhalation, bend that front leg, come all the way back up. And exhale, feel that conscious shifting of your weight in order to open into warrior two. Relax your shoulders, find that power, find that strength in your legs, and that silence through your breathing. Two. One. A little bit more of opening. Slide your right hand down and adjust as much as you want by bending your front knee and open your ribs. Try to look up and feel how your entire body stays lateral. Two. One. Inhale. Feel the strength of your upper body, straightening both legs, and exhale, find your Uddiyana Trikonasana. Looking up, and if you're there comfortably, without too much weight on top of your left lower arm, push your head back. Feel how immediately it opens more your chest. And if you did any variations by bringing your hand on top of your muscle, keeping both shoulders aligned, go for it. Both legs super engaged. Exhale, both hands go down. Reshorten the distance with your back leg a little more, but not too much. What I see very often is that in that moment, we're standing almost with our front leg straight. We still want to have it super far and very diagonal. So inhale, lengthen once more, and keep bending over that front leg, walking back with your fingertips as much as you can, as much as you can. That really is important. And as soon as you have enough pressure on that fingertips, start bending your knee without sinking in with your hips. I know that's a difficult part. And maybe you hug it in, stay there for three. That's all about feeling your center strength. Two, almost there, one step down. It's still a small distance, and walk over with your right hand to the left side. Push into that, or your block if you have it, and straighten up both the left hand. Two, both legs straight. One, exhale, look down. Walk forward with your fingertips. If you're starting just with fingertips, that's pretty fine. And bring up that back leg. Lift it, feel it. Any variations, welcome. And if not, just follow mine. Bend both knees. Walk out that right hand. As less as you need your right hand, the better it would be. Shift that right leg over the left side. Maybe make a bind. And feel how you're starting to find the floor by sitting. So I'm twisting again. Here we are. Take an inhale, lengthening forward. So you're pretty much twisting your navel in front of you. Open both elbows and bend down. So your knee is pretty much, it stays high, and your front foot is in connection with the mat. If you can, do the bind again, lay down completely. Two, it's the grasshopper in a certain kind. There's another variation, we're just preparing. Inhale, come back up. Twist over that very same side. Both hands in front of your mat. Walk back a far distance from you and find your extended ankle pose. If you're low with your arms, stay there. If you prefer to have your elbow on top of your knee, stay there. Always feeling that diagonal line. So you don't want to have your hip too high. Let it sink in and maybe find in the other side. It's always about
looking up to the ceiling, pushing your head back, opening your chest. Two. One. And here we are. We're going to start replacing our left foot with our arm. And it's really important for your own safety that you push into that left arm. So maybe it's just a big toe that remains on the floor. If that's so, it's pretty fine. Start to bring that left leg bending, making a bind with that straight arm. If you feel comfortable pushing down there, you can go deeper. Extending and feeling the twist a little more.
Two.
One.
Slowly stepping down, bringing down your knee. And first we're lengthening here.
Feeling that those hips come back up. Your knee stays on the floor. Your hips are square forward again. Take your right arm up and exhale, twist it. Feel the weight into your variation again. So if you brought your hands together, palm of your hands, just do it again. If you make that bind, do it again. Always twist up. Your gaze comes up. Feel that spine. So it doesn't end just here. It goes all the way up to your neck. And we still want to integrate it by moving our head and feeling more balanced by bringing up our knee, if so. Two. One. Both hands down. Stepping back and finding a short balasana. Bring your forehead down. Your hands beside your body. Relaxing your shoulder blades. Feel all the weight of your shoulders as they are falling over. You can stay with your front forehead on the floor, twisting it from right to left. Feel the release in your neck. Without lifting your forehead. And from here, find your downward facing dog again. So this is a very magical moment very often because you feel that from having your legs bent, it's easier now to extend them back and your entire spine is not changing shape. Okay, so feel that extension through your arms and through your spine, walking back your hands slowly. Feel connection with where you're standing, interlace your big toes, inhale, straighten forward. Feel that spine straight, even looking for an arching position, and exhale, bend down. Your elbows are bending outside. Two. One. Inhale. From here, feel that wavy movement again. When you tuck your chin in and first straighten your neck, and at last your chin opens. In your exhalation, both hands maybe at the same time or one after the other, just below your feet. Inhale, lengthen, and exhale, fold over. Two. One. Inhale, lengthen, once more. Exhale, both hands come out. And we're making our Carmen walkie-walkie into the front. So if you're aware of the wicket, it's our preparation for a press-up. All of you who are new in that class, you can do it. Actually, today I would like to give you two options. If you're already walking forward, you can do it. Shifting your weight, feeling that moment of just having your arms on the floor, activating through your spine. If you rather would like something more dynamic, it's all about feeling weight in your hands. And since we prepared it pretty well, from your Adho Mukha Facing Dog, you can start with some frog jumps into the front. Do, 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 and squat. And the same way back. Okay, and if you feel safe enough, and that gives you some nice rhythm, try your Vinyasa in landing high and squat. Okay, whatever way you can choose to come in front of the mat, if you did it by just walking with your hands or jumping into your Vinyasa, we find our way in front of the mat. A nice small Malasana, so we push our knees up with our elbows, straightening our spine once more, feeling that rooting line from top of our head through our spine and through our hips towards the floor. So there is almost a vertical line
And we're trying to get out that rounded back.
Slowly, we're releasing. We're starting to bring our hips high. Close your legs and roll up vertebra by vertebra, taking a deep inhale. Super. We're making a small variation here. So we're going to bring our right knee up. First, start to just hug it in, keeping your shoulders even, your shoulder blades together. And from here, I would like to give you two options. Option one would be to create a small four shape. I'm going to make it in your front. So the four shape would be that it's just upon your knee. If you're common or known with half lotus, you can do a half lotus. And there the idea would be you could always already make a bind. If not, it's still interesting to make that four shape. If for any reason you prefer that, we're starting to bend forward. Our chest is really opened. If you have that four, you're starting to make a prayer in front and bending. If you have that lotus, you're doing pretty much the same with a half prayer. So if you're in that lotus, you're starting to release your hands in front of you so your heel can get off the ground. It's actually the same that you would do if you have the four. So you bend, take your fingertips as support, bring your heel high and try sitting on that heel, just pushing all your weight through the metatarsus. So the idea would be to find a moment of balance here. Two. One. Hands go back forward. So that's the moment of lifting back and come back up. Super. We release. Maybe we shake it out. And from here, just come to the other side. Choose your variation. This is less intense, especially for our hips and knee. So just choose. If you want to start with a nice bind and feeling how that knee, that bent knee, is actually getting closer and closer to that straight knee, you can try. If not, stay open. Perfect. Both hands go forward. We are bending our front body into the front, making that prayer. Slowly, when there comes that hate where it's really getting difficult for your legs, you can always support going deeper and lifting your heel to find a nice, comfy sitting position on top of your heel. So the idea here is that we start balancing. It's just some playing around. Two. You could always choose to keep at least your index finger on the floor, but work on having a straight back. We are walking back with our fingertips, lifting our heels and slowly finding our line back up. And then exhale, release. We're in front of our mat, so we're stepping back in your exhalation, opening both hands, inhale, come all the way up, both feet are parallel, and exhale. So now I want to see all of those handstand fans to inhale, lengthen your front back, lengthen, opening your chest. And now you just look for the opposite. Bring your palms to the floor, push down, align your ears with your hands and bring up the heels as much as you can, as much as you can. If you can, push deeper and find that release. So if it's not a handstand yet, it's the direction towards it. So feel that belly burning in the center of your body. High, 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 high. And exhale, bend down. Slide your hands in line with your feet. Take another inhale, lengthen. And this time exhale, just fold over. And for all of you who know variations you can go into, you can bring your head down with your elbows bent backwards, keeping them together. Shaping a triangle with your head, you can bring your legs up towards the Muktahasta Shirshasana. If not, you always can choose to rather stay here on working of straightening those legs. If you're in Muktahasta,
find your way back to a bakasana. So first of coming, before coming back to the floor, relax your knees on top of your elbows. And now it's the moment when you start opening slightly more your knees and let that hip sink in. So it gets more, it reaches more weight until that head comes out. Maybe you stay here too.
One step or jump back into your Vinyasa to find that Adho Mukha. And for all of you who stay down, find a way into that Adho Mukha. In your next exhalation, you bend your knees, step or jump to come to sit. Passing forward directly.
So we're going to open up. Super nice. Walking forwards with our hands, just fingertips maybe.
Keeping your shoulder blades together back. So your shoulders are not the first step coming forward. We actually want to have them at the last part getting forward. It's our chin.
Two. Always inhaling. You're lengthening forward, lengthening your throat. And exhale, come deeper. Inhale, walk back up. And exhale, bring your right arm just below left leg. Take an inhale, exhale, bend over. Looking to the ceiling. So you want to lay down with your right shoulder on top of the muscle of your right. We stay here. If you reached the foot, you can stay with the bind. If you're still up, that's absolutely perfect. We're getting a little higher. If not, stay with the bind. Just shift over the right arm to the right side. If you have no bind, just get a bind now with your shin. And if you still have that bind, pull it, bring forward your chest on top of your right leg. And exhale, looking over to the right side, to get a little deeper twist here. Inhale, twist up. Let's stay low with our front body and walk just with our fingertips to the other side. First, left arm goes below our right leg. Roll over, find either your bind or just your flexion, opening all the space in between your ribs. Looking up to the ceiling, so there should be no arm hiding your side. Slowly, if you have no bind again, come slightly up just to bring that bind with your shin. Walk that left arm out to the left side.
Take another inhale, bend over. If you have that bind, keep it and pull it. It's all about lengthening.
Inhale slowly, come back into center, and one more time we stay here. You can choose any variations. Maybe just you connect with that feeling of, I'm getting a little more in it, or what the hell, it really hurts a lot, but that's all sort of getting in.
Two.
One, slowly come back up. So we're closing our legs now. We are just closing the left leg with the right, rolling on top of our mat.
To find the next inhalation, roll up in our Urdhva Mukha and exhale in our Adho Mukha.
I just would like to go into how we come to sit from here. We're finding a way to jump or step or walk into a walking position. So the first level would be to bend the knee, to bend the other, come to sit and straighten. The other way would be to do it a little bit more activated by jumping. So you bend your knee, you jump over, shifting the weight on top of your hands. Without bending, sit and do the same. Good. Just trust your arms. You can do that. And the other version would be to try to pass with your hips your arms. So you want to slide through. It's actually called a jump through. So you bend your knees again. Straightening your arms, so that those straight arms are your safety, that nothing is going to happen as long as they're locked. And make a bounce, find your jump, keep your arms straight, pass through and sit after. So all those different versions are applicable for you. So from here, we go in. into bending our right leg. Make some space with your muscles. Your knees stay together.
And we're going to open up a little more. So first we're going to bend over the left leg. Inhale, lengthen.
And exhale, bend down. So you can either grab your shin or your feet, making a long extended spine.
Focusing with your chin forward.
Come all the way back up. Inhale. And from here, two options.
You can either bring your heel
into your center. It would be the smoother option for any knee injuries. Or you can make a half lotus, even applying that bind. So if you have that bind, you can grab your right foot, just the arch of it, keeping your chest open. Inhale deeply and exhale. If you just have your heel on the floor, just do the same. You can grab your forearm actually, make that kind of alternative bind and bend down. Two, your shoulders are even, always try to adjust them. One, inhale, come back up. Super nice. And slowly release. So we're going into the front now. We have done it in the other class as well. This is just a different way of entering it.
So we bring our hands forward and that leg, which is already bent, we bring it up.
Up to our right elbow. Shift your core all the way on top of your hands and extend your other leg away from you. Ekapala Bakasana. For all of you who know, you can change sides, shifting one knee to the other side, releasing the opposite one, finding a Bakasana maybe even. And in all your own rhythm,
find your Vinyasa into your Adho.
And we're going to step or jump or float again to sit to make the other side. I promise it's the last, what we're going to do, strength-wise.
First of all, inhale, opening and exhale, bend over.
And start pulling that foot. Two. So you still want to sit on both buttocks. Just feel that you're distributing your weight well. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, come back to sit and adjust
by either applying your half lotus or bringing your heel to the perineum.
Half lotus, remember that bind. And if not half lotus, just the same. Your left hand looks for the left palm, foot palm. Make that bind with your forearm. That helps you just to keep your chest open.
And exhale, bend far forward, keeping your shoulders aligned.
Maybe even your chin is touching the floor, perfect. But you want to really land it as far away as possible. Two. One. Inhale, come back up. Exhale, release. And just where you are, here we go. To bring this time our left leg on top of our elbow and straighten back. Two. So you want to have your chest low and your chin really extended forward. This helps you to release the weight of your hips. Step or jump back, come into your downward facing dog, and we find a way to come to sit back. Okay, so from here, this is just a way to go down, but a little bit more activating. So we're grabbing our knees below, giving ourselves a nice hug. Just have in mind, we want to extend our back, we don't want to drop back. So feel, if you need, you can just
put your big toes on the floor. Feel how that helps you to actually straighten. And from there, lean back a little without compromising your position.
Slowly release that bind a little more. You can stay in the half version. Keep that ankle close, close, close. And if not, if you're aware with your full version, stay here. Navasana, three, two, one, and slowly open. Keep your legs straight. If you have them bent, start straightening them and come to lie, but in the most controlled way possible. And lay down. Wonderful. We're going to bring our heels just for the buttocks. Our shoulder blades together. Maybe interlace your hands and push up your hips. So you want to actually with this push into your mat with the help of straightening, as if you would be straightening your legs. Bring your chest closer to your chin and feel how at the same time you're extending your neck. Two. One. And if you're there comfortably and want to go a little deeper, you can support your lower back with your hands. And first, before going anywhere, feel that you're giving all the weight on top of your palms, your hands. So you can hug in one knee, keeping that arch, keeping that pressure on top of your hands. And you can bring the other one. Remember, it's not about straightening our back. We still want to be arching and opening our chest. If you're comfortable there, you can extend your legs. And this is the moment when it gets interesting, when you exhale, bend down, and without falling, feel that you can arch more and more and more until your legs, your feet actually touch the floor. Super. When you get there, exhale slowly, bring your hips down. And two options, you can repeat this version or just stay a little bit more opening your chest, working on that arch, or you can go directly into your walk down the wall, whatever you might need. Give yourself a couple of minutes to find your arching. If you're just in the classic Urdhva Dandasana, stay there for 5 breathings. Feel a shifting of the weight more on top of your hands. Maybe straightening your legs, opening more your chest. Super. And whenever you come down, give yourself a nice hug. Flatten your back on top of your mat. A nice auto massage from right to left. And from here we're going to extend the left leg, bending over the right leg, flexed, bent, and extend your right arm. Push your knee down, looking over your right shoulder. Release the tension of that very intense arching. Both shoulder blades touching the floor. Slowly inhale, come back to center. One more time, hugging. Flatten your back. Lengthen the right leg. Bend over and help yourself with your arm and pushing that knee down. Opening your left arm in T shape. And exhale, look over that left shoulder. Two, one. Inhale, come back to center. Hugging in one more time. Making a really round back. So actually, you can just play with it a little. It's not about too much inertia. Just try that you're hugging or you're taking a bind with one wrist and you're starting to push away your knees so you automatically are rounding your back. You can come up to sitting. Let's try it just once more. Feel the distance between your knees and your chest. Come back. So it's not at all about really getting forward with pushing. It's about straightening your legs, pulling your arms, rounding your upper back, and come to sit. And when you're here, you can do the same. Rolling back, straightening your arms, and shifting your weight over your head. Finding your Salamba Sarvangasana. We're going into this in a short version, so just stay here, finding your breaths, finding your rhythm, any variations that you would like to apply, but especially feeling that line and supporting your upper back as high as possible, maybe even getting to your shoulder blades, looking towards your feet. Exhale, bend your knees slowly, staying straight with your back and relaxing them on top of your front, of your forehead. Feel a moment, a second of all weight possible with your legs on top of your forehead, activating the third eye. With your palms placed back on the mat,
start rolling back on the mat in the most extended way. Try to connect with all those vertebrae, that each of it gets to lie on the floor with its own space.
Two. One. Until you come down. So there are two options now. It's almost time for Shavasana, but since I promised, now we're going into some variations of Shirshasana headstand. So a typical way to get out here is Chakrasana, and since in rocket we apply it and it's very ashtangi, I just propose it, so you can try it. If there are any neck issues, be aware. Just be aware to not charge too much weight on that neck. So we literally want to place our palms next to our ears, okay? And we're going backwards, so we don't want to do fast movements because you lose control of what is actually happening. So we're trying it pretty slow. Literally the same that we did before, by bringing up our hip to come to Shirshasana. This time we have our hands placed very open and we roll over, maybe touching the floor behind, walking further back until you feel there is this moment of pushing into your hands and roll out. Okay? This was very slowly, so you would like to apply a little bit more speed, but just to know your steps, okay?
So it's all about pushing in order to release your neck. If you're not comfortable with doing that, an option to come back to sitting is always bending your knees. Come forward, step or jump, and find your downward facing dog. And from here we reach the final exercise, Shirshasana.
So this is especially for all of you who have Shirshasana more or less tried once or twice.
We're going to measure, first of all, our elbows, interlace our fingers and fit our head in it. So we want to always have consciously pushing our elbows back, elbows into the floor.
The first step would be to push our hips up and walk our feet towards our heads. So we don't want to have to jump up. We want to automatically lose weight on our feet because our hips are always already shifting that weight on top of our head. And from here, the first step would be to hug your knees in. Find that line in your back. Find your neck extended. And from here, come up. If you're comfortable here, first exercise is to breathe. Arrive at the present moment here and be the guide of your own practice here. So you come back into your breathing rhythm, into your concentration especially. And slowly, if you're comfortable here, always distributing your weight between elbows and head and hands.
You can start to just twist your entire body to the left side. Your head stays where it is and your shoulders as well.
Keeping your line, be aware of your line and of your concentration, and twist to the other side. Maybe there's some vertebrae spreading, twist back. You don't have to force the twist, it can be just a little twist, as long as you don't lose that line. If you're still comfortable, we are getting our way into actually a preparation for Pinchamayurasana, so try to transfer a little more weight on top of your elbows. Push into them. Stay with your head looking towards the mat and try to push up, keeping that line. Maybe it's just a push up and land again. Be aware of not falling back, I hope it doesn't happen. And if you're really safe and keep that line and your entire body is under control, you can try once more to find that space, push up as much as you can,
place your palms on the mat, and at last shift your weight into your pincha. And you can come back the same way.
So wherever you go, if you just stayed in your classic pincha, you're always welcome to do what you feel to do. Find your relax way back into a direct balasana, giving your bloodstream a chance to redistribute. Feel your heartbeat. Feel the weight rooting down your entire physical body. slowly straighten your hands into the front for the last time.
Feel the connection with the mat, feel it in between your fingers, under your palms, and come into your last Adho Mukha. Check into that position one more time.
Bend your knees, feel it smooth. Find your way, maybe not too activated still yet. Back to sit, to lie. Extend all the body on top of the mat. Palms looking up. Take three deep inhalations through the nose. And exhale through the mouth. Another time. Invite all that space into your body and exhale. Just release and free yourself from anything that is not necessary anymore to you. It's like an uncleaning through the breathing. And from now, each exhalation should just be a tool for you to root down even more, to feel all that weight and relaxation in your body. There's no more control. You're just falling, falling and deeper falling. Stay in Shavasana, your eyes closed. We're going to listen to some Tibetan Buddha's chanting, which have been recorded in the Himalaya. It's something that I really like to close the practice. So just listen to it and maybe feel inspired by it to just let go of anything else, what there is in your minds. Shavasana is all about losing control, not trying to have control of your body, of any situation. Just enjoy the present moment of your very pure existence, of your body living, moving all of itself.
Oh,
Feel your temperature, feel all little movements that you're starting to do again in order to enter, re-enter your body. Moving your fingers, your feet, doing any other gesture or movement that your body is asking for. Now is the very moment when you're listening to yourself. When you really connect it with your inner being, and give yourself all that attention and love and devotion to find your own way back in your own rhythm, to come back to sit on top of the mat, legs crossed, palms of your hands placed on top of your knees. Feel that connection. Feel one more time that very initial position, and maybe all its changes that you recognize. The relaxation in your shoulders, the way how they're hanging and heavy now, your legs, their weight on the mat, the connection, all points of contact with the mat. Feel your roots on the mat, your chest and your heart opened. And all those little changes that have happened in your mind, and maybe in your physical sensations throughout that practice. Give yourself a smile, feeling grateful for today's practice, bringing your palms together in the center of your chest. If there was a dedication for today's practice, just bring it back to your mind. Take a deep inhale to close today's class. And exhale, incline your head, relax your shoulders, let them hang low, free from any tensions. Namaste.